So today we are going to discuss about cost of capital. So under cost of capital, what we are going to find out is when we are selecting a project based on the capital budget decisions, and now we want to accumulate the fund for that investment. From where we can accumulate fund, definitely we look into a source whose cost is less. I mean, the cost of tuning up the fund is less. So in such situations, we have to calculate the cost of each and every source, and from that we have to find the better source whose cost is less. Otherwise we have to mix up all the source into a capital. We will have different money from different sources in which we will find out. So in the case of cost of capital, we have the following types. First is cost of debts, that is for bonds, then cost of preference capital, cost of equity capital, and finally the weighted average cost of capital. These are the four things which we are involved in the cost of capital. First thing is the cost of debt. These three are the sources of finance we have, because when we are planning to invest into a project, we can accumulate money from these sources. The first one is the cost of debt. That means accumulating money by selling bonds. So we have to calculate the cost, because the bonds has different factors which affects its cost, say like their face value, their issue price, maybe at par, at premium, at discount, flotation cost, many things are involved. So we have to find out the cost of debts, and if it is cheap, we can go by that. Next is the cost of preference capital. That is the money which you accumulate by selling preference shares. Preference shares is a type of share in which the dividend paid will be fixed. Whatever may be the profit or loss of the company will pay you a fixed dividend every year. And we have to find the cost of preference capital as well, because it includes tax, concessions, then the flotation cost, many things are involved. So we have to find out the preference capital cost as well. Then the cost of equity capital, the money which we accumulate by selling equity shares, it also involves some cost. Then we can decide which source we have to use. Definitely the company will not go by one source. They will go by different source, and they will accumulate money from all these sources. For example, they may take 50% from equity, 25% from preference, and 25% from bonds. Their capital will be structured in such manner. So when we are mixing all these things, you have to take the average cost. That's the weighted average cost of capital. Okay. So by calculating this, we can calculate the cost which is going to incur in our investments, and based on that cost we can plan our investments, right? So these are the four things. The first one is the cost of debt, that is for bonds. I mean, the debt instruments all have the tax concession. So when you have the tax, your cost will again come down. And in the bonds case, we have two types of calculation. That is the cost of bonds with maturity period and without maturity period. Then you have the preference capital. There also we have preference capital calculation, in which you have the tax concession again. In that we have two types of calculation, in which one for redeemable preference shares, and the next is for irredeemable preference shares. That is maturity period is known. Then equity capital, it's very simple, based on the market price of the share, and we will calculate. Then the weighted average cost of capital. These are the four things which we involve in cost of capital. Now you may ask a question, why not bank loans are involved here? Why? Because banks are also one of the sources of finance. We don't want to calculate the cost of money which you are borrowing from the bonds, because the cost is known. The percentage which you are paying as interest is known to you. So we don't want to have a different calculation or formula to be applied to find the cost of the money which is being borrowed from the bank. But for all these things, you have many variables which influence the cost. For example, in debts of, in the case of bonds, the variables which influence the cost can be the difference between the issue price and the market price. That means if the issue price is more than the face value, that means that you are selling the bonds at premium. If you are selling at the face value, means it will be called as it is issued at par. If you are selling below the face value, means you will be called as at discount. So variables comes there. So you cannot assume the coupon rate as the cost of the bond. You can't, because these factors, for example, if it is sold at premium, means the cost of the bond should be less than the coupon rate. If it is at par, means equivalent to coupon rate. If you are selling the debts less than the par value, that is at discount, means the cost of the bond will be always more than the coupon rate. So don't think that the coupon interest which the company is paying to the bond every year is the only cost involved. No, that cost can be adjusted, can be increased or decreased by having different variables like the tax, the issue price at premium or issue price at discount. Many things comes there in between which influence the cost. In the cost of preference capital, again we have the tax concession, and again the issue price and so many factors comes in between. You have the flotation cost in between. So these things will again disturb changes the cost of preference capital. So you don't come into a conclusion that the preference dividend rate will be the cost of preference capital. Definitely not. Variables will affect it and it will change it. And equity capital, I don't want to explain much about equity capital, because there are n number of variables which affect it, which affects the market price. So in that also it will change, and no company will promise you that they will pay you this much definite percentage of equity dividend. Definitely not. So there also it will change. So that's why these sources are involved in calculating the cost of capital, and this is the reason why borrowings are not involved, because they don't have any face value or any type of variables which is going to affect their interest rate. Only the interest rate is taken as the cost. Okay, so now let us discuss these factors one by one. And first we are going to discuss about the cost of debts, that is the cost of bonds. So bonds is an instrument which comes into the debt category. That means when companies will issue the bond and an investor will buy the bond, and investor will give money for that bonds, and these bonds will have a fixed coupon rate and a face value and maturity period. For example, if it is a 5 years bond, means the company will pay an interest amount every year, that is the coupon percentage, which is a percentage of the face value, and at the end of the maturity period it will pay back the face value. So that's all about the bond. So the variables which affects the price of the bonds are the issue price and the tax things. Okay, so let us discuss the cost of bonds. And first is the cost of bonds without interest rate, without the maturity period. We are going to calculate the cost without maturity period. When a bond is given without a maturity period, for example, you are going to find the cost of a bond in which the maturity period is not mentioned. In such cases, you have to use the formula KD is equal to INT by B0. KD equal to INT by B0, where INT is interest paid every year divided by issue price of the bond. That is, INT means the interest, the coupon paid every year, and BO is the issue price of the bond. This is the case without tax. So this is a formula where we have to use when there is no maturity period and tax. In the case if the tax is given, the formula will change. KD is equal to INT into 1 minus T divided by B0, where T is the tax rate. This is for with tax. This is a formula when tax is given. Interest paid every year into 1 minus tax percentage by the issue price of the bond. Why the tax is reduced there is the only the debts has the tax advantage, because first after receiving all the amount, all the income, we pay the cost, then we pay the interest, only then we pay the tax. So interest, in that interest payment, it includes all the interest paid to the bank borrowings and to the bonds, everything will be included. So the debt instruments always has a tax advantage. That is why tax is reduced, and that will bring down your cost. So these are two formula. One is with tax and another one is without tax. These two formula comes under the situation when maturity period is not given. If maturity period is given, the formula will change further. So let us see one example and then we can calculate. A company issues bonds of rupees 50,000, 8%. A company issue a bond that is 50,000 rupees per bond and 8% is the coupon interest. And you are asked to find the cost of debt at par and with 50% tax rate. Okay. So bond issue price of the bond is rupees 50,000. The company issues a bond at rupees 50,000. Coupon rate, that is your interest, 8%. And it is clearly given the company is issuing bond at par. At par means face value. So this is the face value. Both are same. Issue price and the face value will be same when it is issued at par. At par means at face value. If it is issued at premium, this will not be equal. The face value will be 50,000 and the issue price will be more than 50,000 if the case is at premium. At discount means face value will be 50,000 and the issue price will be less than 50,000. Now the situation is it is issued at par. And you have to find the cost of debt. What is being given? It is given a bond is issued at rupees 50,000 at par, and the coupon interest rate is 8%, and the face value is, since it is at par, it is again 50,000, and you are asked to find out the cost of debt. So the formula for cost of debt is KD is equal to, here since the maturity period is not given and the tax is not given, the formula is INT by B0. Now we have to find out these two variables. Interest, how much? 8% of the face value. So 8% of rupees 50,000 is equal to rupees 4,000 is your interest every year. And the issue price is at par. So 50,000. Now apply these variables in the formula, you will get 4,000 divided by issue price 50,000, and you will get cost of debt as 8%. The same. Now you may ask a question. The same coupon rate is same the cost of debt. Why? because there is no much variables. The amount paid and the issue price, everything is not dynamic, it is constant.